Hello and welcome back. This might be one of the more unsound decisions I've made as a commander, but looking at the overall situations here, and I will get into detail briefly in a moment, but well, I decided to not delay our attack on Tixa any further and finally get this done with. Even if we, you know, depending on how well this attack on the surface goes, we might, leave the dungeon for later, as at least until we have moved some equipment back here, back and forth. So, but the reason why I'm doing this in advance, or in preparation if you will, is, well, between these two sectors, it takes like almost 2 hours to travel. And the truck here, well, this is another 3.5 hour round trip or something like this, and there's probably this roadblock here has been replenished by the queen, so we would have to take them out again, you know, another stop, another distraction we don't really need. And also we don't really have any body we could spare right now to drive the truck. This this group is busy here, 20 militia at the moment, and the other are practicing since they, you know, don't have anything better to do. And just for guys, it's really not strong enough to take on these patrols. They have progressed in terms of equipment and skill, so, but I would really like to clear this road because, well, this ice cream truck is it cannot go off-road no matter what, so we cannot take the direct route here to Darsen, but only this one to the north of Armor here. So yeah, we have to clear the way. And the same thing here, I think the Sam side and Tixa are only accessible from the south here with their little service road. So yeah, we probably have to take the truck all the way around if we want to make use of this, or here even it should be a little safer perhaps. Let's worry about it later. Another little problem I had with this arrangement here was, well, these guys were all done. Militia is trained at 100%, as best it's gonna get by training alone. And we also taught some valuable lessons here to Vince, for instance. Yeah, he's now up to 41 marksmanship. And we also invested some time in Flo and Ruben, but their progress wasn't as speedy. But 52, almost 53, it's not bad. And Ruben is at 54 right now, so also, yeah, he is doing the best he can with his limited smarts, so can't really blame him there. Yeah, and yeah, everyone was rested and we were just finished, all came together, so I just decided to go ahead and yeah, you know, try our luck here. And another thing I wanted to mention briefly, well, as you maybe have seen here, Gumpy is on his way here. He will arrive today and he will, for the time being, he's gonna drive the truck around and move some items. That is okay, but I'm still considering forming a third squad finally. And well, the primary purpose of this of these guys would be to clean out some of the patrols who snuck past our rather useless mobile militia. I think this roadblock has been re-established once again. And well, for this we need like 5 or 6 guys. They don't have to be the most experienced or well equipped, you know, just some little cleaning up in our backyard here behind the front lines. Some light work, and Gumpy could be on this team together with Shank and Dynamo, and you know, 1 or 2 more experienced mercs to help them out. And maybe we can kick Flo and Ruben off here, the front lines, and replace them with some other new recruits. I'm fairly certain I will not extend Brain's contract. His performance has in no way reflected the money we dumped into him, and I really regret, you know, getting him signed on in the first place. But what can you do? Stats-wise and everything, there was no reason to suspect that his performance would be so lackluster. Yeah, compared to Gary, that is. He's the, you know, proficient in the same areas, but he hasn't let us down nearly as often. So he's gonna stay, and I haven't fully decided who his replacements will be. But for, you know, I know what was for 2 weeks. I would have to check briefly here. Yeah, since he leveled up a couple of times in terms of experience, his daily course is 270. Yeah, actually, this would be easier to check it from here.
I'm better now.
Yep. Yeah, almost, actually 36,000. We can probably hire 2 or 3 cheap mercs from AIM here. Maybe Screw or something, you know, Screw and Grizzly, perhaps, and someone else, maybe, maybe Leech or something like this, well, to fill our numbers here, boost our manpower a little bit. Once again, I haven't made up my mind entirely on this point. It's something to ponder off screen, but let's get to work here. I think we have 20 guys. Yeah, most of our camouflage is worn off already, but yeah, this will be a long range engagement. At least the first phase will be, and it will probably allow us to kill off half the team or something like this. At the very least, we will probably have to go into the prison itself and do some close range fighting, but yeah, this guy is fairly durable with bodybuilding and good armor and this rocket launcher, grenade launcher. Assuming he doesn't whiff all his shots as in the past, but there's hope, you know. Yeah, and this is another thing we bought with us here, with smoke grenades, HE grenades, and of course flashes already loaded. And we also picked up some weapons that we did the best we could cover up here from the SAMSITE sector. Yeah, Vinny has these M16 with some grenades here and a 3x scope for closer up engagements. At least for the dungeon or something like this, this K98K even with a 2x scope wouldn't be very useful, so... Also, everyone needs a gas mask. I made sure everyone has one in their inventory. Certainly when we go down there, it is gonna be a requirement. Ira with a 4x scope didn't have a pressing need for something else to pick up. And this revolver is still pretty good. We have decent ammo for it as well, because you know, I spent a little bit of money. HPS and some glazers, not that we were going to use them probably. Some of these enemies have hard-coded armor or something, I would suspect, but armor piercing and HPS will do just fine. Flow, well, it's not going to be a point woman anyway, but this is this is a perfectly service firearm close up, as is a pistol. Ruben, same. I gave Dimitri this SR1, well, SR2 actually. The SR1 is the pistol companion to this thing. All the ammo we could carry. I think this is all of it, actually. This is for the dungeon, for the most part, and he also has a buckshot that works equally well, you know. Mad Dog, I already talked about in terms of guns. We didn't find anything better for Brain, and this down there, his primary firearm will be the grenade launcher, anyhow. So yeah. And Miguel always has, also has the another rocket grenade launcher. Why do I always mix this up? Oh, never mind. And I picked up some pistol here, the Code Elite and 10mm. Excellent sidearm, but with the ambidextrous trait, well, maybe we can find another pistol up here before we go down there, and then he can make good use of his action points, even though he is claustrophobic, so his performance it's all in the specific sectors here, yeah, in the subterranean. I think it's limited to this. I'm not sure what the penalty is, but probably like -25% in action points or something like this. Mm-hmm. Not sure if chance to hit is affected or not. And I swapped out his rifle here. This is for Mad Dog's PKM. Seems a little more sensible than the 3x scope. And for this, long range fighting in the desert. Obviously, how it goes. And with that out of the way, it's time to get started here and get the job done, I hope.
I become smarter.
Yeah, good job. This takes longer.
I'm proud to be working for you.
Someone chasing us, but we are already out of the way, in between sectors, so we cannot get surprised here. Okay, that's interesting. Usually they do not chase you around if you have a large group like this, and they are in the they cannot match you in terms of manpower. What was I about to say here? This group is really a lot slower when training, or less efficient. Yeah, because they don't have the experience, but they really couldn't spare anyone else. And Scream is already already had to detach him from our attack force here to train up some mobile militia. So, but I think we can make do without him.
I think there's trouble around
here.
Good
thing we don't have to worry about reinforcements coming up from behind, you know. That's fortunate. And let's see here. I don't recall the layout of this map, to be honest. But I do. I do remember that some of the perimeter is mined, and there is a sort of alarm system here. Once you have made your presence known, this entire section here will be filled with tear gas, lethal, of course. Yeah, but if you try to sneak away, there's a backdoor here or something we could break in, but I don't think it's gonna be feasible during the day with our squad. So it's probably going to be another instance here of moving up to the front and killing them as they, you know, come running at us. There's also the warden here, another NPC. I'm not sure what equipment is, but probably won't be in the same league as Mike. Yeah, no way. Okay, let's see here, our firing angles. If there's a backdoor and they have the key to it, then maybe someone would try to come and flank us. We should be mindful of that possibility. But then you should stay down here and snipe across the entrance or something if you can. And then Ira, should... But maybe Ira should stay up here just in case with someone else. We do have enough people. We don't have everyone covered up across the front entrance here. That is not really necessary. And breaking into this backside, maybe we could make that happen somehow. But I don't quite recall what the wire cutter situation is. I'm sorry. I would have to check this once we're on the battlefield. Yeah, Ruben can stick with Ira. That's actually... Ruben does have a better scope now, so maybe he should take some pot shots. Yeah. Right, but we can leave Vince over there. He isn't gonna be particularly accurate anyhow. Mad Dog with his medium machine gun can lay down here some time. And Brain can maybe move to the back here with some support if he can make that happen. With Vince maybe or something like this. Well, we can move people around as necessary. It's not really important.
The army! Okay. I knew we'd see them sooner or later!
We already see an elite on patrol back here. That's concerning. Has he spotted us?
Yes, sir!
Doesn't seem like it, but we have to take him out right away before he has a chance to use his rifle at us or whatever he's wielding. Okay,
You got my ear!
May have been a mistake to leave some people up here, now we're coming running around here and we are really short on camouflage and...
Yes, sir!
Camouflage and cover. Well, maybe we have to retreat up here and get some distance between us and this fence line. Well, first we have to take him out.
Sir!
That's for certain. Can't really trust Vince to do this, to be honest. It's even a little close for his scope anyway,
You got my
Ira
ear!
Has the wrong scope attached as well, so that's not fantastic.
Blah.
But Brain has the 4x scope, so maybe he can take him out. Okay, we can take a knee and then move over here and take some shots. I hope that will work for us. Oh, it doesn't look like particularly... is this a blind shot? I can't tell from this cursor. Oh, we tried it anyway. Good start. One well-aimed shot, I guess it is then. And still wounded because we're shooting at hollow points. 9mm, 9x9mm for that matter. Yeah, okay, okay, he took aim at us, I think. Yeah, that's what to be expected, and you know, go prone, and Ira,
you got my ear.
Take one shot from here, and then go prone as well, maybe. I didn't expect to end in contact, you know, end up in contact right away. So I would have put the 4x scope on here, while it was a free action, but yeah, it's too late now. Take a knee and then fire and then go prone. Make it the best shot you can. Oh, thank you.
Flip an
right,
A!
Even then, next opportunity we get, we move further away. We can still watch down this passageway with the 7x scope, that's fine. But now we have to, move away some of the pressure here, if we can. Maybe fire some blind shots down here, doesn't matter if anyone's there or not. Aim for these explosive barrels perhaps, and it should make a large enough ruckus to get their attention and divert them away from these guys, which are, more vulnerable at the moment, of course. Right, let's see real quick here. Can't see anyone, maybe someone on the roof, could be, it's probable.
Yo!
Okay, Vinny. These guys are so covered up, that's
yes.
Really great, but Alright, we take up some good spots if we can. And then, I put Slugs back in. Okay. That's good. Another guy who might be on our kill list this very turn. Yo. If he can make that happen from the crouch position. We'll see about that. Looks pretty decent. Let's give it a try. Not the effect I was hoping for, but what can you do? Maybe so Ruben what? Can follow up with something decent. Where's Ruben actually? I cannot see him. Well, let's just stay here and put a bullet into her if he can. Probably, yeah, actually. You know, he has progressed in terms of abilities. I'm quite surprised by this. Credit where credit is due. He's become quite a passable mercenary. Yep. And now she is almost dead, maybe bleeding out or something. That would be an ideal solution for us, so we don't have to worry about her. But then again, yes. The other person, two engagements ago, wow, they were poor and not bleeding, so... Wait, you should probably hit the dirt and keep watch for us, yep. And these other guys have already spent their action points, except for Mad Dog, and he needs to get his light machine gun ready pronto. Unfortunately, this path is blocked, so he doesn't have enough action points to... Get everything set up as I... Yeah, actually, just, okay, with two action points in reserve. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And that leaves us with a flowback here for some support. Mm-hmm. Flow has... lost. No, it doesn't matter. We don't have the kits to spare. They're all used up and there weren't any replacement. There's no S drops. So, yeah, let's go here. And the alarm should be sounded right away, I think. Watch out for snipers, yeah, that's a given. But so far we have avoided the dreaded 10 times scoop shots from half the map away. Civilians is probably the warden. Yeah.
We? Oui.
Mm-hmm. Right, first things first, these guys move further away. We should keep overwatch.
Yes, sir!
You got my ear!
Yes, sir! Wind should retreat first, yeah, that's okay, but we don't know about landmines, so we should clear the way first with Brain before we do anything else, and then, yeah, Ivor needs to move up behind the
supporter
at the very least, so she doesn't get shot as easily. And then crawl forward one time, maybe, yeah, and then change heading, actually, that seems to, yeah, you would have to, okay, let's do it right away. Okie dokie, that's all taken care of, I hope. And then Mad Dog needs to crawl up further. So he can look for his scope, actually. Something. Must be some of the boulders here in the way. We don't want that. Let's not get too close because of his mediocre camouflage. Again, we couldn't reapply it. But 41 isn't terrible, even though it's wood.
Yes.
Wood land. Right.
See, soldier!
Okay, another one down there. That's good to know.
So what?
Putting our new little tricks here to good use. And maybe we can make this blind shot work for us. I would rather move these guys into cover, of course, but since we do have the opportunity to take them out here, let's do that right away. But okay, no way he could see us.
So
what? All safe then for the time being. And let's see, we do aim for the torso. Mm-hmm. Good. And then Ruben can maybe follow up.
So what?
Ah, it's again pretty good. Oh, unfortunate, but maybe this could do the trick. Indeed it did. Good work, Ruben. Mm-hmm. Well deserved once again. Impressed by you. Good work. And then we can call you up a little further perhaps, since you do have a very good camouflage. This seems good enough, I think. Mm-hmm. And that's our turn. Okay, she's bleeding, excellent. We will probably fall over and collapse pretty soon. It's interesting that we haven't been rushed yet, to be honest. They lost the alarm. The tear gas, once again, takes a long time for these procs to process. One after another. Yeah, sorry, nothing I can do about this to speed this up, it's just how it is.
Yes?
Must have been the warden triggering the alarm yet then, since it was on her turn, the civilian turn it is. Alrighty, 18, 17 in the bleeding person, but the warden is also hostile, so it's still up to 19.
You got my ear!
Okay, effectively that is. We could maybe blow a hole with our explosive we bought, but I think there are civilians in these cells and we don't want to hurt them, obviously. Again, I'm not entirely sure what the layout of this place is. This is the warden's house, yeah, on the prison grounds. Yeah, that tells you about their mindset. I think these are barracks. This is of course the front entrance here. This could be a little storage shed with the truck and probably some gas in there. And this is the canteen maybe. The common area, and this is the prison block, of course. And the dungeon, the entrance to the dungeon should be back here somewhere, but they cannot get reinforcements from subterranean sectors. It's not allowed by the game.
Yes!
Unfortunately. Yeah, this way first. And then. Maybe we can take a peek into the courtyard here, if you scroll. Just a little bit.
Alright, yes.
We need more intel, please. Move up to here if you can.
Okay.
And the others will cover you.
So, what?
Ruben can... Where's the better camouflage? Ruben is 63 and Vinny is... Or 61, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Then we can maybe move up a little further here as well, where we can. Mm-hmm. Yep, that's much better. And then Ruben should probably move to this border here or something if he can. And Vinny stays back for now. Resources and action points, and then we still have a rock.
You got my
right
ear!
Here. Yeah, okay. Oh, ready your rifle then, since there isn't a backdoor here as far as I can tell, but we want to keep the. Isn't the lockdown?
Yes,
and
sir!
Maybe it isn't necessary to move so far away after all, but we should at least check over here so we don't get. We don't get a flank from there. It might happen. There is a door here somewhere, probably. Or they could just come running around in this entire perimeter, even though it's very unlikely.
Yes, sir!
Honest. And then, your scope isn't ready, right? Now it is, but it's not a very good angle, so, we have to find some better spot for you, maybe from here. Yeah, and you can keep watch with Iowa for now, and then if nothing occurs back here, we can maybe cut through the fence.
Yeah.
Let's see, do we have wire cutters? I actually do, that's fortunate. Okay, then we can consider that option if all goes well.
You got my ear! There's the enemy!
Okay, reinforcements are coming to the front sector, but we have a flank shot here, potentially.
I'm learning!
Yep. It was very good at another level of experience. There's 7 for Ira. You know, by the end of the campaign, we might get her up to 8 or 9. Who knows? Certainly a very competent markswoman. Yeah, this guy's probably toast. Fair to guess. Probably also bleeding. Certainly doesn't have enough extra points to do anything right now.
You got my ear!
Alright, maybe you can finish him off with or something like this, but it's not really necessary, to be honest. I don't think so. But it might be work for some target practice. Every shot adds to this.
Yeah.
Even missed shots, I think, but not nearly to the same extent, of course. Alright, we hold position up there for now, and then we can do some cleanup maybe down here. It'd be great.
Yes! So, what?
Please move it.
Okay.
Yes!
Okay, we put the binoculars away for time being for better peripheral vision, and we whip them back out once we get down here or something like that.
Agreed!
Okay. Right.
You got my ear!
Yes, sir!
And that's our turn, and flow is a little useless in this position. Maybe you can move her forward a little bit as well. Yeah, I should be fine to stay crouched here. Yep. Okay, and then. Perfect. Bleeding. Okay, where was the door? We didn't see. Okay, civilian turn takes a long time. Because they know there are prisoners and the warden and also her husband and some children, although they aren't hostile to us. I think the husband's actually pretty relieved when you finally put a bullet in her brain. It's a really mean person, this warden. Really cruel and sadistic even, so yeah, there was no love lost there between those two. Was not a happy marriage, to say the least. So, well, the guard post is clear, we know that for certain, so this should be fine to take. Yeah, well, from the guard position perhaps this is a line of sight blocker, but also offers
so
a great protection. And we have Ruben, please continue. And then we need other people up here as well. Flo is a little dicey with her crappy camouflage, so probably not her.
We?
Yeah. Yeah, that doesn't help us, of course.
Yeah, yeah.
You already have good eyes on this sector.
Yo.
And Vinny can use this opportunity to reload. That's good. And then we put the... actually, just nudges in the end of the time. And then we ready your rifle. And Dimitri,
yes.
Keep some... Well, this seems to be clear. We would have spotted someone already here coming running at us, so...
Yes, sir!
Yeah, I don't think this could have escaped our notice, since there isn't a backdoor on this side as far as we know.
Yes!
Although that said, this wire frame here, that can be a little tricky, as you know, but I really don't see anything back here. No windows, no openings, no anything, so... Yeah. Yeah, that should be... I assume it's good enough, or safe enough for the time being, and you can do more scouting, perhaps? It's probably pointless to leave you up here. There's nothing going on, so maybe you can move it back down here to this blind side and then cut through the fence, yeah. It's better than you wasting your time up there doing nothing. Good one.
Oui.
And then... Well, this might be safe enough for you, but again... Yeah, why not? Okay, but next time we get started on the next turn, at least we wait until Miguel and Ruben are finally in position here. He's bleeding, yep. It's good. Would be quite fitting here, bleeding out next to these tombstones. Of all the helpless civilians they've tortured and killed and starved to death and what they're doing here, it's very...
I know this area very well. I long feared it would be me inside. Haruko's worst prison is here, and the warden, she live on the premises in a small house. She be a mean woman, evil enough to be Didriana's sister.
Always wanted to do this, and here we go.
This pretty much what I said, you know? Yeah. Alright, that was a little unfortunate here with the real-time combat engaging, so I didn't get opportunity here
so
to move
what?
These guys up, and now we are at least is someone stuck in this bright light, I don't think so actually.
Yes.
Miguel might be. Alright, since there really does appear to be a backdoor here, so I was incorrect, so that's good that
yes,
we
sir.
Didn't move up so far already. I mean, so close to the fence, so do have to find some other approach then, maybe from back here. Or at least, I don't know how many people will be in this building, to be honest, or how many guards, I should say. Maybe we can do this safely regardless, and then take this building first in some fashion, or at least make sure it's clear to a reasonable extent. Alrighty, I don't think this is a... No. Give it a try. Was hoping for better effect here, but
the
problem again with this... rifle is, yeah, it's only 4.45 by 39, and that really is semi-automatic. It's not really all that powerful. It's an intermediate cartridge and a pretty wimpy one at that against heavier body armor, at least than Jack the Lion, so... Okay, that solved the problem once again. These old battle rifles are really good. They're worth keeping around, and then we can move Brain back here since there isn't anything going on here, apparently, so... Well, actually... maybe we can stay up here for a couple more turns and off these people as they come running out of this door. Yeah. Easier than than breaching and doing close combat fighting, right? Okay. A lot safer too.
So what?
Even though probably we'll come to that anyway, but now we cannot go crouched here. It seems actually doing daytime might not matter so much. Brightness 100, well, it's not much of a difference to be honest.
I will teach them!
Yep, let's do that real quick here with
Nighthawk,
hopefully. If this, assuming this isn't blocked. Yeah. And we had to switch to. Oh, of course, this gun has a burst mode. I forgot there is the one advantage of this thing, even though it's really way too heavy for its caliber. Okay, it did no damage because it pierced through something. That's unfortunate, but maybe you can help out then here. This is another elite, most likely. Yeah, okay. But this might be the better shot. Yeah. I'd rather take the better chances to hit here, so let's get started on whatever this lieutenant is doing here.
Ah!
Yeah. Well, what can you do?
Yes?
And then... Well, this seems like a waste
of ammo. I no see it good!
Weave?
Flo, yeah, just stay behind this rock then. Yeah, that's good enough. And go prone since your camouflage is crappy. And then Ruben.
So what?
Ruben, what can Ruben do? Is probably block.
Crazy yeah. idea.
Yeah, of course, these boulders are in the way. What else? But you can maybe go here and crouch. And then look over there and ready your rifle and then take some shots next turn. Potentially. And
yes.
Miguel needs to hit the dirt again. And then even maybe ready his rifle. You can get some shots around here, at least for this corner, when he gets line of sight. Could work out for us. Yep, and then maybe call you, retreat you a little bit if you can. If you cannot kill them off fast enough. Well, I'm not coming. Obviously leaving the dirty work up to us, right? Yeah.
Yes.
Right, well then...
So, what?
Yeah, yeah!
Already?
Then yes.
at least provide some, intel here for our, this designated marksman, so we can take
some
shots at them.
Yeah, yeah!
It's unfortunate that we are not in grenade range, but yeah.
So,
can
what?
You do? Would this be a safe shot to take? Well, I don't want to shoot Miguel in the head, obviously. Not that these shots are... Oh, this looks pretty decent, to be honest. Well, if you aim with the torso, it should be safe enough, I hope. Oh. Yep. Good shot. Good shot. And then this vehicle. Yeah, this is fine. We can shoot through here. And maybe take out one of these guys. This looks like a better chance to hit it. It might hit the front guy anyway. It was a piercing shot, so almost no damage, and also hit him in the legs. It tends to
yes?
be pretty wimpy in terms of damage anyway, so yeah, it's all blocked by the guard post. So, not coming through here, obviously, so yeah, just roll you over some. Then maybe we can get around this guard post next turn and use your shotgun with the rifle shotgun choke. And Flo then keeps watch over here though. It's most important that we have some eyes over here so we don't get a shot from the other side from of the fence, you know. And
what
do we do with these guys up here? Brandon can come around again. These guys, you know, they keep watching.
You
That's
got my
okay.
ear.
Just keep this door covered and then we can make our way through the fence. But crawling here seems to be a little dangerous. So we just crawl all the way down here and then, you know. We can press against this wall if we have to, so we don't have to, waltz through the main entrance. Someone maybe laying in wait for us there. Okay, they're retreating,
yes.
interesting.
Yes.
Some of them are.
Yes.
I wonder where the warden is. Normally she joins her guards in combat right away. And then insults you as soon as he spots
yes,
any
sir.
Mercenaries.
Yeah, okay.
It's not only you know a real mean person, but also bad mouthed. So.
Yes. I no see it good.
Maybe we could take the guard post, and that would offer us some elevated line of sight down here into this courtyard. Even though I did nerf the sandbags, of course, it works both ways.
So what?
Nah, no, it's not butter, I don't think. Yo! And... that looks much better. Yeah, something is piercing here. The fence shouldn't reduce the penetration power of these bullets by a lot, to be honest. It's just 2 points of armor or something like this. It's just a chain link fence, I mean. but it is peaceful here. I can't really tell. I couldn't really tell. It's a little
so what?
Hard to keep track of these bullets flying where they go in these isometric games. But then, you know, if we don't have anything better to do, we might as well just take some pot shots down here. Yeah, it was it's connected anyhow, so
yes.
Good job there, once again. Yep, and then Dimitri can come around or something, so he isn't completely useless up there.
Yeah, yeah.
And you are still set up here and watching, and
oui,
same
you
for
got
these
my
other
ear.
People. Mm-hmm. I did already miss it, right? Yep.
Yes. Yes. Hell.
Yep, yep, so like 5 or 6 guys there.
Yes.
Is another guard here, most likely. We cannot, we just don't have eyes on it at the moment.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Then let's do a quick head count here before I lose track. Yeah, I go to the game with the wrong button. Okay. 16, we can see, let's say, 6 at the front entrance and 1 guy bleeding out somewhere. Or 2 guys bleeding out. So, plus the warden, that's probably 9 guys still we are unawares of. And where would they be? Yeah, but they would probably garrison this common area. I think there are some dining tables here and these hallways. Yeah. It's gonna be occupied most likely. Mm-hmm. It's let's just go with that assumption for now, and then
so
maybe
what?
We can finally move you up a little bit since they don't come rushing us. That should be safe to call up a little further.
Okay,
and
okay.
The spot you just you know left, you can take up as someone else. Probably
yes,
Dimitri or something.
Okay.
Temporarily.
Mm-hmm. Oui.
Flo needs to keep watching this, and maybe you can move Vinnie closer. But actually, it worked out quite well here with his 7x scope. That's why I put it on this rifle, you know.
Hey, I okay. Need slugs!
With piercing the sandbags, that's why this damage was so poor. Good thing, well, we still have plenty of ammo left, but then we can maybe change the position down here. Next turn or something like this, or get started on this at the very least, and then you continue, yeah. Please. And let's
you got
check
my
the
ear.
Here, seems fine. Mm-hmm. Still.
Yes, sir.
Already. It's a shame our machine gun isn't
yes.
Really in position to burst on here. It would have provided us with lots of opportunities, you know,
yes.
To get some saturation fire going on, hit multiple targets.
Yes.
It's pretty much unaimed fire, but nevertheless pretty effective. Even if the suppression effect
yes.
Isn't as effective, you know, one turn after another, you know, it adds up, and then they just get pinned down here, and you can just take shots at them
yeah,
with
yeah.
The leisure, and then keep them down with the machine gun.
Oh.
Yeah, something like this. It was actually pretty decent, and now one guy taken out, one poor, and fell down, actually standing, and the other guy collapsed, okay. Yeah. There were 2 or 3 more guys back here we cannot see at the moment in this building here.
Yes.
Dimitri is moving up, okay. Ruben is moving
so
up.
So what?
Yeah. Okay, then maybe you can finally see him, see them here with your scope. Eventually, we will get there,
yeah.
I hope. Yep.
Yo!
Oh, you were also moving up, it's okay.
Yo.
And flow and yeah, keeps watch over there for the fence. That's fine. Yeah, they're running away, seeking cover.
Yes.
No, some of them are.
Yes.
I really need to get eyes on that door. I mean, with someone who can actually shoot at that range.
Yes.
This is out of reach here for his night vision scope. With,
so what?
With marginal effectiveness during daylight. Just crouch, they don't look in our way right now, and then you can go prone here and ready your rifle, and then we should hopefully get an interrupt or two next turn.
Yes!
And you have, we let your action points recharge, and then actually just run, it should be fine. I know it's a little risky, but it's taken long enough already, you know. Don't want to waste too much time if we don't, if we can avoid this. Alright.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe you can shoot some bursts on these buildings. I'm not sure about penetration power. Yeah, it looks pretty terrible, to be honest. Let's not bother.
Oui.
It's only a 5.56 NATO. So not the stellar choice for shooting through walls. He just can crouch, it's fine. And then, yeah, he isn't the fastest, as you have noticed, yeah?
You got my ear!
Alrighty.
We?
All taken care of for now. Yo! For Vinny, you can just run up here as well, it's fine. And then hopefully we have the scalpers out of our line of fire. Yeah. Someone bleeding? Maybe the guy we shot
Lex or something? This makes me mad!
I really wonder why they don't come running at us. It's unusual. That makes it easier, yes, of course, for us to pick them off, but still, I would prefer to have this engagement work on some Yo. Other way. Right, please look for your scope. Okay, then we don't flow over here anymore since it's now covered by Vinny, and then she can maybe join for the chaining fence here, yeah?
We?
Yep, it's, even though her armor isn't perfect, but it's not terrible. Well, she does have a fast rifle, and if that fails, she has an even faster pistol loaded with the best armor we can get for it. So it should, at least with some well-aimed headshots, it should make short work of these guards at close range. But first things first, of course, we have to get a brain into position finally to cut for defense. Yeah, and just run here, that takes way too long. Come on. Yeah, as you can see, there were 77 action points, and he only got that far.
Yes,
he is a beefy fellow, but very slow.
You got
and then
my
we
ear.
Can, you know, fall back here gradually,
yes,
and you can go with brain. Right, and then vacate this position, and you can hopefully get into finally get into a better position down here with running. Wrong key, of course. What's going on? It's just a little oopsie there. And you keep your head down for now and then get in position next turn.
Yes.
Alright, you aren't even pressed against the boulder, that's not good. But didn't
so
hurt us,
what?
Unfortunately. Mm-hmm. You can wait for an interrupt.
Yo!
Vinny is set up and
so
is
what?
Set up. Dimitri is set up, okay. All good and well, I hope.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yep, that's all good and well, but they didn't
yes.
walk far enough to get
so
seen by someone else, except for this guy. Okay, and he's hopefully will bite the dust here. Oh, groin shot is pretty painful.
This make me mad.
Mm-hmm. Another guy coming out of the door. But nobody had enough action points to do anything about it, okay.
So what?
But once we've taken care of these guys here at the front, I will probably make a small cut in the video. Since this is getting pretty repetitive, I know, I'm sorry, but it's really another safe way to do this. And all these guys here, I mean, we're attempting from some flanking attacks here eventually, but these are so slow, you know, in weird time, it takes forever for them to get anywhere, even when running. Yeah, it's not really anything I can change there.
Yes, sir!
And, I will stay up here for now, and then we can you know, your arm set up, so let's change that. We go here, over here, go prone and ready your machine gun, and then excellent, now we can finally burst them down if we have to. And,
yes, sir!
Yeah.
So what?
Okay, poor with a handgun, doesn't matter so much, but this is not a very good shot. Maybe Vinny can take this one instead. No, I don't think so. Maybe we wait for an interrupt then. Then Ruben, just take a portrait as this front guy here first, please. Nope, okay, it's too bad.
Yes.
This doesn't work, right? I wouldn't expect it to.
So what?
Yes.
It's probably A just freaking out.
So what?
Oh, okay, that's good to know.
Yes.
And yeah, we can't do anything about it.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yet.
Damn. Yes.
Oh, lots of interrupts. By the way, if you get interrupts, that awards you a very small amount of experience.
What?
So that there's the warden.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Thank you for all these interrupts. She's only armed with a handgun, apparently.
Yes.
That's interesting. Yeah, get on with it already, please. We don't need interrupts, we need people with the ability to shoot.
Yes.
Right. So, we can finally get this started, maybe. I don't want to advance across this, obviously, with all the enemies down there. That seems like a terrible idea, but now we can finally at least take some shots, I hope.
Yo!
Yeah, but they all ventured out of our line of sight. This is not so swell. Alrighty then, please go to the fence here, both of you. Ah, and so there are landmines, it wasn't just my faulty memory. Oh, then we just have to take it nice and slow, follow in his footsteps. And then, we lose the other way to crouch here, okay.
The
little Congo line, since Vince isn't very experienced yet, we don't want him to step on a landmine.
You got my ear!
And then Ira needs to keep watch here, and we saw some other guy here, so we should leave her here as well, looking that way. That's okay. Deactivate the street subs, please, and then we just have to wait for another interrupts again. I'm sorry.
So what? So what?
Okay. Interesting.
Yeah.
Good. Good. It's finally taken care of here. This line, and then we can cut for the fence already and get going.
Cool.
Yep. Thank you. And then you want to here. Move it to there. Pick up some position here and get prone.
Yes, sir.
And then we press up here also against the wall and watch down here.
Can I pull their legs off with my bare hands, please?
Right.
Yes, sir.
It always selects the mercenary who spots the enemy, you know. So almost moved Madoc out of position. Alrighty. Who is the person you can see? Okay.
You got my ear.
But I guess I can Miguel not see him. It's interesting. Oh, no matter. Just bursted him. That's why we bought this gun. Well, there's
I love myself.
Well, there's one advantage to this heavy, gun, light machine gun in caliber, but heavy in raid, that it is a very stable firing platform because, of course, 5.56 has very little recoil in 500 prone position in a firearm such as this.
Yes, sir.
Alrighty.
You got my ear.
Yo.
Yeah, you can. A little further, that's okay, and then maybe you can finally see someone down there in the courtyard. It would be swell. And then Flo is now available for the flanking team as well, but she's also very slow, so it will take her ages to get up there in real time. So if I do this, then actually just get started on this. Yep, and then I eventually get to the off screen probably.
Yo.
The Vinster's got one!
So what?
That was a good hit.
I spit at you!
Yep. Spiteful as always there, Ruben.
So what?
Alright, I think I should make a little cut here. This is just too repetitive, and then get back to you if something interesting occurs. You know, if we get closer to the courtyard for some more shooty-shooty at closer ranges, or if our flanking team is finally in position to do something productive. Yeah, we know there's like 4 or 5 guys plus the warden running around there, so once again half the enemy team unaccounted for, yeah. Well, we still have some work ahead of us then. Right, so I found out why the enemy turn takes so long, as well as the civilian turns. Well, guess what? There are hostile civilians here in this sector. I'm not sure what they are supposed to represent. Probably private guards here on the warden's payroll. Yeah, and as you can see, it's a convention up here. There are more than this here, so I'm not sure what the total number of enemies in this sector is, actually. That's... peculiar to say the least,
so,
and there's
what?
Of course also another guy at this front post here, stationed or something, locked behind a door or something, I would guess. So, yep, but he doesn't have to worry about anymore.
You want I shoot guys? Get me bullets.
Yeah, we have plenty of bullets for your left, that's good. Next turn perhaps. Yeah, but up here now means that these guys are very too far away from the action. Yeah, but this flanking attack it worked out so far, I think, I'm not sure what we can do here in terms of... we have slugs loaded still, maybe we can make it count. Yeah, well, for some reason they have camouflage up here, even though Flo can see them. Actually, Flo can only see one, and Vince can see the rest of them because he's crouched, I would suspect. Well, and just shoot at the one you can see, and maybe you can take a, make a kit here. Mm-hmm. Okay. Dying, but no, oh, that's bad. That just means a bug triggered and this guy will never die. Yeah, I just have to reload this, I'm sorry. Well, the alternative would be to, you know, just, use cheat codes basically to finish him once the rest of the sector's been cleared, and I don't want to do this. Quirky as always, Jagged Alliance, much appreciated here. He's supposed to fall off the roof, that is. Yeah, okay, where were we? Oh, still some, place. I think
yes,
Vince, Vinny first here, Vince, oh, come on, what is it with your temperamento nature today? Ah, Jesus, man. Why do you have to ruin my flow? Oh. Yeah, this is another screwy aspect of this game. When you try to jump off roofs or onto roofs, the jump times it just bugs out entirely. Yeah, that's also great. Yep, there are all these wonderful people down there, and
so what?
Ruben still has to work to do here. I think maybe you can. Well, we might hit it. Okay, it was excellent here.
You want I shoot guys? Get me bullets.
Oui. I'm not sure if random seeds are a thing in this game. It's
yes.
In XCOM, the newer ones. So you cannot save scum, you know, by default, because the RNG numbers, they've already, the rows, they've already been predetermined, so you always get the same outcome. Yeah. Right, let's take another save here before we trigger this bug again. I'm not sure why this happens. Doesn't seem to be a particular pattern to it. Yeah, again, he's supposed to fall off the roof, but he doesn't, so maybe I should just aim for his legs or something. Or just fire someone else. I don't think saving and reloading the sector fixes this. It's a permanent thing, a permanent bug. I think it is until the sector's been cleared entirely. So, yeah. Why can we not see them? Is it because I applied open camouflage to her since she does have the kit, or had the kit. Right. It shouldn't. Now you can't see anything. That's fantastic. Oh, whatever, but
yes?
I would like to take the shot, maybe we tie the legs or something this time. It's better than triggering a bug, I suppose. So, and you don't have
yes,
any
sir.
Action points for a shot, right? If I recall correctly. Yeah, and then these guys, once again, like I've just said, they're too far away from the action, but maybe we can... Well, that looks pretty terrible, but you never know. We can fight very, very long burst and hope for a hit. Yeah, that's all you can do. 104 action points, thanks to Miguel's quantitative bonuses. Alright.
Ah, sugar bush.
Yeah, it's better than nothing. Okay, and
yes,
you don't have any action points, and these guys, well, they are completely out of position, but once again, there should be enemies down here as well, still, so you cannot really ignore this angle entirely, that's for certain. And Brain, well, this is too, well, maybe you should join the action on the roof, but... Well, going past these windows, we would have to... I mean, we could stand up here and then sidestep and look into this building, but it seems a little risky, you know, we don't, although I don't, I didn't get any audio cues from down here, so maybe not, but we can at least move you up a little further and then get an interrupt when someone comes around the corner, even though that shouldn't be, shouldn't really be a possibility if we have all angles covered. But we really need to move up here then, so get these guys back into the action. But how can we safely do this? Well, there's absolutely no cover here, so it would be... Oh, it would take forever to... Well, maybe we just take that risk with someone, I think, or something, then... Now, the let's see if we get shot approach isn't really a favorite in my playbook, to be honest. So maybe you take a baby steps here
and
forward by one or two tiles at a time with one mercenary and then leapfrog and cover each other with Overwatch as we do. Mm-hmm. since you haven't spotted anyone, maybe you can find this better spot for you to do this then.
Okay, you got my ear.
Needs to keep watching this back door, that's okay. I'm not sure what the,
see them.
I'm not sure what the equipment is in terms of being able to see us through scopes. But we seem to have the advantage at the moment.
Enemy!
Okay, yeah, well, that's what I thought, more guys down there.
Yo!
Good thing we left some people here, right? That's a really crappy shot, why is it so bad? Probably it would be a piercing shot or something like this, whoops. Yeah, the head seems to be the best, offer the best odds here in terms of being able to hit it. Well, was not to be as expected, but maybe this will do. Nope.
Merde!
Hell! Yo!
Yeah, more targets to for us to shoot at. Maybe triggering the bucket would be great. Maybe Vince can get started here.
Yes, sir!
Actually, let's double check here.
Yes?
You can see only the standing people. Yep, it's unexpected. I mean, it's expected.
Oui.
It seems to be, has been the case. Yeah, maybe could we crouch here safely? Could probably, and then see them. Mm-hmm. Alright.
Yes?
We can take one shot and then get back down. Okay. If you really don't want to stand up or you stay crouched on the roof,
oui.
To be honest, it's really quite dangerous. Poor, okay. No, shoot him, don't talk to him. Mm-hmm. And then get down so Vince doesn't shoot you back in the back of the head.
Yes, sir!
And let's see what about targets here. I don't think you can trigger the bucket if they are crouched here. Yeah, it's only in standing stance, I think. Critical, poor, okay. Odds aren't fantastic, so we just pick one target here and roll with it. That's great. Can we fall out with that? Yep, we could, and now she's poor.
Yes!
Alright, and wounded, okay, but wounded is not too much in terms of action point reduction, to be honest, so healthy, yeah. Seems to be a better shot, to be honest, so let's give it a try. Good, good, and now here's something to think about, and we go prone again. Even though it's a little risky, because now we don't have any action points, and in case someone tries to come up here and, you know. But yeah, we should put Brain here up here as well, and then he can sit back here and, you know, take pot shots on anyone who's jumping up here, and this is already covered by Vinny.
So what?
So yeah, what indeed? You need to reload. So don't forget here. Let's put some fresh magazine in there. Actually, I think this is in real life. This would be reloaded by stripper clips, but I didn't want to implement another. You can in per caliber. If you have have one magazine. In this case, it's the same as the SVD. And if I were to implement a stripper clip, you know, it wouldn't matter. These would be interchangeable because they have the same magazine capacity. So I would have had to change this to someone unrealistic, like 9 or 11, or same for the SVD. So yeah, let's not bother. It is little details that don't really matter that much, and certainly in terms of gameplay. Right, this is blocked, but maybe we can take some more pot shots over here, some blind fire. It is, this seems odds of success are a little higher here, I would think. And indeed, yeah, this is supposed to be animation. Yeah, this is the animation is supposed to trigger.
You got my ear!
Very nicely done, actually, I quite like it.
Yes!
It's even better if you shoot them close up and then you get another spray of blood or something, that's if I recall correctly. So, Miguel needs to move up further here to get some binocular vision. And, well, we cannot see anything really. It's a shame you don't have the scouting trail, but what can you do? Alright, and the others are all set.
Yo!
Yes!
Alright. Can someone come? No. Maybe she saw some. Okay, yeah, that's what I thought. Someone in the courtyard still.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, who can help out here? Maybe we should start on. Actually, leave the roof,
so
the roof for last, and maybe we can. Yeah, it looks good. Try it.
Ah.
Piercing. Unfortunate.
Yo.
Yeah, and you wait for an interrupt again, I guess.
You
didn't get an interrupt because I spent all your action points on blind fire. Silly me, but now we can ready your rifle and then take one shot here, or even a little off auto fire. Aim low because you have trouble with that muzzle clamp, if I recall correctly. Seems good. Now she should be critical, yep.
Yeah, yeah.
The Hedgehog leaves action points in reserve. Same for Vinny. And then let's see upstairs. We have to keep in mind there's at least one or two guys in the courtyard and they could decide to jump up here, but they will not blindly throw grenades if I recall correctly. Certainly what I would attempt to do. If I knew that this roof was occupied. Right. Poor, healthy, yeah. He is the primary target, even though he hasn't been doing anything, not even moving.
Your
performance is better than I'd expected. Certainly, the translate cursor doesn't seem to be as optimistic. Right, and let's just finish this, I guess. Or maybe not. Well, was not to be, and then
yes,
Dimitri can pop back up, and then maybe. Well, it doesn't really matter, but. Take one shot at her and then get back down. Yep.
Good show.
And Brain keeps Overwatch.
Okay, this yeah. Make me mad.
Prime opportunity here. Should be burst or take a longer. It's probably blocked. No. Then we have to aim for the head most likely. Yo. If we do want to hit him.
Yeah.
Have any hope here at least. Yeah, that's what the chance to hit causer seems to agree with. Right. So let's try this. Wow, at least you had a little bit of fun, right? Yeah. Bleeding, good.
Yes.
Yeah, we can finish him off maybe with Vinny. Well, finish him off, he wasn't injured to begin with, but now he's almost dead, so that's good.
So what?
And you can... Well, actually, we should leave that up to Miguel, perhaps.
Yes.
Actually, we don't have to bother at all because she's bleeding, right? Yeah, we're thinning out the hurt a little bit, but once again, these hostile civilians that are not represented here in the enemy count, so I really don't know how many there are.
Yes,
but
sir!
It's fun taking these pot shots on the roof, we don't often get this opportunity. Yeah.
Yes!
Well, let's not worry about this too much. Maybe we can even, oh, there's another strong one. That's good to know. Poor strong. It's a regular enemy, right? Yeah. I know he isn't strong anymore.
Hell.
Yeah, they're retreating but bleeding, so maybe they bleed off screen or something. That would be.
Soldiers!
Work just as well for us. Okay, let's finish him off if we can. Good. And then maybe the same for him.
Goodbye.
Here. Nope. Okay, what can you do?
Yes, sir!
Well, you want to get eyes on the back guy before he can retreat, so we don't have to hunt him down. Oh, unfortunately, we cannot see him at the moment, so maybe Flo can at least get some fire onto him here. And. No, apparently not. Okay.
Yes.
What leaves us with something to do down here, probably. Oh, let's just give that away.
Hey, I need slugs!
Maybe you should we stick with ammo next turn. This. Okay, but we're running a little low on here 9mm, 8mm Mauser, so. Yeah, we can just buy more. Actually, this are stacks of 4, right? Yeah, well, it's not that pressing as I thought.
Yeah.
Okay.
So what?
We just don't bother here, and then Miguel can move up a little further and make use of this.
Yes!
Because we finally have to take up this, front entrance, and this seems to be clear now, since we shot one guy down here and made a whole mess out of this place here anyway. So, this is really close before this camouflage situation. Maybe we can risk it. With baby steps. Yeah, also put some ammo here for Dimitri as much as he could carry. Yep, okay, I'll just stay where you are for now, that's all fine.
Soldiers!
Yes, sir!
Mm-hmm, another strong one. Good. Wow.
Yes, sir!
probably the newer builds would offer more of a challenge in terms of the AI. They wouldn't just let you do this, you know, sit on the roof the whole time, take pot shots at the other side. Yeah, it would be a little more challenging, I would imagine. Okay, good. Seems yeah. Okay, critical, that's fine.
We?
Now we did not have the ammo to be honest, but you need the experience, so maybe you can hit one of these shots finally. Nope. Interesting,
yes.
I mean it always impacts down here. Where are you even moving to be aiming for, excuse me. Just finish off if you can.
Good job! Then we no bullets!
Then we, we do it from the prone position. The next turn will take up the next turn, of course, and then
yes!
Red cover for Miguel. So actually,
what?
Move up now. Then we can put Mad Dog back here next turn, something like this. Or in two turns. Oh, I forgot to reload Vinny. Oh, it's getting long for me as well. This engagement, it's been, I don't know, like almost 2 hours, including off screen, so. Yeah, I should probably do another cut here and take a little break, and then I'm not sure how much work is left for us here. Maybe not as much as, you know, at least from the on-screen part. Might not be necessary to do the rest here. Interesting. Yeah, that's very good. We did see that. So that could have been a rude awakening.
Yes.
Okay, maybe Vinny is in position to take some shots at them. Oh, not at this guy.
What's the matter with you?
Maybe if you were to get a little closer or some other angle here, that would maybe offer us a chance to do this. But yeah, it's no. It's not possible at all, or is it just it's just the action points, okay. Was got a little concerned there for time.
Yes.
Maybe now Ruben is in the way, which is a little bad, but looks like it would be it's no one over there right now, so maybe it would be a better option to try this instead. Yeah. Okay,
yes.
And then maybe you should call some people back here, so I'm not sure what their line of sight
so
would be.
What?
Since they seem to be stationary and not doing anything, but you never know, you know, that seems a little dicey. But
yes.
Well, let's take this over one tail at the very least. It's better than nothing. And then Vinny is in position in terms of action points, fully reloaded and everything.
Yes.
And then maybe we can move someone up to this edge here. And it's a little dicey if people down here, they might get an interrupt on us. But you would be the best candidate to do this, I think. Well, you do have to reload. Let's switch to Buckshot. Yeah, since we are almost out of. Slugs, excuse me, and then we have to change the choke as well, which will take yet another turn or even two. I'm not sure if we can just swap it. This is a remove and then attach kind of situation, and can move your way over there, and maybe you don't think you could do this except for the very edge, so, but this seems to be a little clearer for now. Okay, ready? See anything? Yep, he's still a strong guy over there, that's good to know.
We?
Let's just fire widely over here. Okay, one hit, that's better than nothing, and you still have to kill Overwatch, that's fine. Sorry for the inaction for you over here, but you know, someone has to do it, but Ira can finally get a move on
Osaki.
There's no one coming here, I don't think. And even if they well. Yeah, but leave you. Yeah, actually, move you over there, and then we can get another angle in this courtyard, perhaps. Okay, let's try that.
Got a thug.
Mm-hmm. I fix these guys, then I spit at the bodies.
Yep.
Guys, see me.
I hope they don't. Yep, they don't. It's just.
You got my ear.
It's just a voice line from Dead Alliance 1 that we used. That's okay. Nothing to get worried about. So, and then now we have the correct angle, and we can then move up as far as we have to, but load should also be an order 5 of 8 isn't too bad, but this wouldn't offer us the best line of sight, of course. It's too far away still to look into this courtyard proper, but now maybe Vinny's in position to take the civilians out here. No, he's not, okay. Then I'm not sure what the angle here is, to be honest.
So what?
Ruben, maybe? Now we can try. Good job once again, wow.
I come get you!
Yeah, you came for them, and now they are pretty screwed.
Personally, yeah. I'll shoot at anything.
Doesn't work.
Just don't expect me to hit it.
What could you? We have to get this female soldier here out of our line of sight. So she doesn't get the chance to do anything.
Fantastic.
Just in case, you know, it's on the safe side, and then is there absolutely no chance to hit here? Oh, it looks like it. Okay, it's just a job for Ruben then, maybe.
Yo.
Seems to be too tough here in terms of being able to pierce this. Okay, it's too bad, but we can just look at this in case he runs out of the door or something. It seems to be just content to be remain stationary. And
yes,
we can maybe take some other shots over here and get him down to critical or something. Yeah, poor. And yeah, now he's critical. Good job there. Another point of marksmanship. You know, experience does pay off. He is a really quick learner and firing off these bullets even though they don't hit. Well, most of them get, surprisingly enough, it's a valuable experience, and he's almost up to level 3 as well, so that's good.
Yes!
And let's not forget about this. Can we swap this out? Nope, okay, cannot. So we have to do this. Man, I think it's 80 action points actually, and you don't. Yeah, 80 it is. Okay, that's fine. Yeah.
We?
Flow, what can Flow do? Crawl up a little further and peek into the courtyard. Mm-hmm. Since you do have urban camouflage, you have the best chance of not being spotted immediately.
We?
The enemy turn is getting very short. Not sure about the civilians here. Seems to be a little long still, and I have no idea where the warden went. Yeah, how many enemies are still here? Officially, that is 4. Okay. So we know there's one guy here and another one who has retreated. There may be another stationary one down there or somewhere. Who knows? Okay.
So what?
Can you please put the bullet in his head as well? It would be Svar. Doesn't look like it, to be honest. But nobody else has died. Oh, okay, that's some light metal there. Okay, some light metal structure. Well, how do we get someone else to see this guy, you know?
Yo!
Maybe we have to get Corvini over here or something like this? I'm not sure. But this just doesn't work here for with metal, that is. So... cannot pierce this with his current loadout, no matter what. This would be another nice instance to here. It's another instance, my pardons, where it would be good to have, you know, anti-material rifle of some description, but this is really late game stuff, so I guess I could buy some. I think I saw one, but it's really heavy, and the ammo is really rare and really expensive, but you know, you don't really use this as a general purpose sniper rifle. It's just too heavy and too slow, and you know, the ammo situation I just explained, so yeah. How can you make yourself useful in this situation? Well, that looks a lot better. Maybe you can hit him.
What's the matter with you?
Oh, let's give it a try. It was not a piercing shot, but it seemed like the angle at least was good. Alright, let's check upstairs with our rooftop guys here. I'll just do my practice shots here, that's okay. Oh, it's unfortunate, but it still netted you, you know, like a tiny bit of marksmanship.
Yes!
Okay, and you can hopefully finally swap these chokes here. Good, good. Excellent. And now we have the improved shotgun choke on there for our buckshot. And then we can, I don't know, move up.
Okay,
no, let's check real quick here. And let's not crouch, that is a stupid idea. Next turn, and then you can move to this edge, maybe. Mm-hmm. Slowly but surely, and Brain as usual provides overwatch. Can move up a little bit, perhaps. Yeah, just a smidge. And look in the right direction, and that's our turn then. Okay, took extra, so maybe didn't see us.
Oh my!
Okay, another civilian down there? Are you serious? Yeah, lots of civilians here. I wish they would provide more intel than this, but to be honest, it wasn't designed for these large enemy groups. This is a modding thing. Yeah, I know it's a little risky to run around here in the open, but yeah, we have been watching the store the entire time, and it's probably entirely has been cleared out of enemies here. Didn't hear or see anyone, but it doesn't really mean it's, you know, could just be another stationary civilian guy somewhere, so yeah. Okay, someone down there, you didn't see him? Or you saw him briefly?
Les autres!
You're making a huge mistake!
Well, I'm not so sure about that lady, but now we go back, of course. Maybe you can chuck some grenades for down there with the launcher we brought. We can finally get into the action here. Let's see. Assuming, of course, you don't disappoint me again. Actually, the range looks fantastic. I didn't expect it to be this good. It's probably not gonna work, right? Yep, another whiff, of course. You know, I already made up my mind. You will not see a contract extension, no matter what. I think there wasn't a single grenade hit you. I told you to make, and you whiffed every single one of them, which is just fantastic.
Yes, sir.
All this money wasted on you because you're just, your stats. Well, they might be good and all, but your combat experience, your combat performance, it just goes contrary to this.
One for Arulko.
Yep, and I don't know, 10,000 yes. to go or something like this. Obviously we cannot leave Flo back there. That's way too dangerous. One time back, please. And yes. Dimitri, I would like to throw a grenade with you, but if you stand up, all of these guys and their mother will get an interrupt. But we can perhaps take one shot.
Good. We will all die together.
Okay, we didn't know there were this many guys back here. That's good to know. Another grenade target, if we can make that hit, you know. Yeah, looking at you, Brain. But how much action point would it takes? Let's check me quick. It takes 20 to crawl back. Okay, so we have a 94 for a shot. I don't think this is gonna work out too well. Poor strong, obviously. This guy should be shot in the back, and 44 should maybe work out. Just good, good. Very good, good actually. Show. And then we can crawl back, of course. So, whoop, goodbye. Yeah, that's our turn, and then we can check with Flo next round if they're still down there, and maybe yes. chuck another grenade over there if we can. Yeah, oh, this video is getting really quite tense. I didn't expect the action to pick up like this. Okay, there's still one guy here we cannot see because he went prone. That's unfortunate. So this is still a no-go. He could just, we try to go past here. He's gonna stay crouched, crouch up and then take a shot at us. That's not really an option, but... Could you perhaps finally throw a grenade on there or something? Or make yourself useful? Would be great.
Merde!
Yep. Merde indeed. And would be even more merde if, if this still misses. Oh. Maybe I should just use a different grenade than this, incendiary perhaps, even if it's slightly off, it would at least have some area of effect. Or mustard gas even, but probably she has, gas mask, it would make sense. Yeah, let's just try the incendiary then and don't stop bother here with this, high explosive. And then, please, can you maybe, finally get this on target? That would be swell. It's still a whiff, isn't it? No, actually, wow, it was on target once. Enjoy the heat here, ma'am. And then we can do the same thing as last turn. Hell. And who should be the lucky one here? The healthy guy, of course. We don't have enough action points, right? Maybe a pistol shot instead. Oh, this even this submachine gun we bought again. 21 turn. So we have 43 at our disposal, if I didn't miscount, so we're one shot we can take here.
Oh, I make proud.
Wow, another level of experience, it's good. We go back here. Alrighty,
yes,
and
sir.
Vince, I can check over here, maybe. Also with one tile. Okay, and then we can maybe pop up next turn or something like this, okay. And Flo, of course, needs to come back before I forget, so she doesn't get shot. Yep. Okay, and Ira isn't really particularly useful in this scenario, but at least we can have you in position here. And watching key is, someone walks around this corner or something like this.
Yes.
The situation down here is still unresolved. So what do we do about this? Grenade launcher? Actually, we do have grenade launcher here. But you're not proficient with this thing. And we cannot unload these grenades. We can fight them as they are right now because this was this new attachment system, this incompatibility, but we can't really unload them or swap out ammo. This doesn't work, so we are stuck with flashbangs for now. What other options do we have here? I don't think we do, except for waiting.
Yo!
That is an unfortunate situation, but Ruben maybe should crawl back to tiles while he can, same for Miguel, really, we don't want to get interrupted here or something. And then we can maybe have our rifle trained here, and
I
was considering moving along here, right? Yeah, so maybe you can get a shot off or something, potentially. Or he might just stay there crouched the whole time, then we have fun some other way off screen, that is. I'm not going to take you with this all the way. It's already very long engagement. Alright, let's double check, everyone is in the correct spot, okay. Yeah, the warden ran out of the fire, unfortunate, but... okay. So, this must be the same guy, so we can finally deal with him,
yes.
That's good.
So, what?
He's looking the wrong way, that's why he didn't see us.
Yes.
Who has their rifle ready? I think you have. Maybe, Metok needs the experience, so he should take him out if he can. You cannot burst twice, right, per turn? Nope. Actually, actually, he could, okay. Yeah, a wooden boss was good enough.
Did it hurt?
Moron. Yeah, I hope so. And then we hope for Peter over here.
Merde.
Okay, now we cannot see the warden, so I'm not sure where she went. Out of the fire, obviously.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's not just besides the point right now. Maybe. Well, we have more of these. They're also cheaper, so yeah, let's give it a try. And I think there was one guy back here or something like this. Maybe we could check with Dimitri before we commit.
Yes.
So it isn't another whiff, assuming we could get it on target. We don't know, must be... Okay, and we just assume there is someone down here. Yeah, okay, let's... pull it here, if you can, that assuming that is, yeah. Okay, it was good to hit, at least from the sound of it, and we can... we load another HE right away, and... what is this?
Yes.
Guys, who can you see, actually? Who can you see? That's the question. Someone in the flames here somewhere and unaware of the sea? Oh, of course the warden. Again, we need 20 action points to move back.
I no see it good!
Yeah, then aim for the head, I guess. Unfortunate, what can you do? So that we don't have enough action points right for another shot. 19? No, I don't know, that wouldn't work out, so... It's too dangerous to leave you this close to the edge. What can you see? The warden as well? Yeah, okay, let's try one shot here. Is this a kill? Actually dying, that's good enough, and then you crawl back, okay. Good job, Flo. I didn't,
you got my ear!
I don't regret you bringing along, excuse me. It's getting really long, I really have to take a break from this, but let's leave the camera rolling for one or two more turns, and then I can, you know, rest for half an hour or so and come back finishing this mission. But so far, I think it was a pretty fun run for me, and I hope for you as well, yeah?
So what?
Let's check real quick here, so we don't get screwed over by nasty surprises.
Mm-hmm. Yo!
Okay, everything seems to be in order down there. Okay. There can't be more than a couple of guys left in this sector by the turns. So, yeah, two enemies. Okay, one I think collapsed and bleeding out, and then I don't know, like two or three more civilians. Yeah, but I really need to take a break. So see you in a moment, and then if I don't find anything else interesting to show you on screen, it's gonna be just a little after action report, you know, as usual. So see you in a second. Alright, we have a little problem here. Well, I did take care of all the remaining guards here, no problem. I think there was one back here guarding the way to the dungeon, another one on the roof, and some stragglers here, some civilians behind locked doors. What else? Well,
caution! I sure I hear a voice!
Yeah, and this voice is Dynamo, and well, for some reason he's hostile, and I know why this is not supposed to happen. Maybe. These presence of these armed civilians here, they interfere with his group assignment or something. I have a very faint memory running into this issue before on this particular map here. I mean, it's not the first time I play on Wildfire, you know. That's really strange. But yeah, he's hostile to us, and there's absolutely no way to turn him as far as I can tell.
Is the merc gonna be surprised?
I'd even tried, retweeting every single merc for a great hit in morale and coming back. It wastes like 3.5 hours as well, but he's still hostile. You can give him items to trigger the dialogue, but from there, there is no way to do anything about it, because combat is technically still ongoing, you know, so yeah, we have to kill him to end this engagement. There's no way around it, but well, I don't want to kill him. You know, it wasn't my fault. It was some kind of bug we ran into here, and the game screwed us over. Maybe I can, you know, well, the option would be to, you know, go back to my quick save and then enter the sector. And then just use the cheat codes to kill every enemy on the map, because we want this fair and square. You know, there's, yeah, they can take this away from us, but then we also lose all the experience and, you know, the advancement and marksmanship and everything. And I don't think that's fair. So maybe what I can do instead is to spawn him with cheat codes and then recruit him. But you know, well, first thing he has to go, we have to kill him. There's, I don't see the alternative. Hopefully, since he's considered hostile for some reason, we don't get a penalty here in loyalty. But the Nemo would be really swell to have around, not just as a mercenary, but also, yeah, there's a quest this involves in here. For a big chunk of loyalty boost and armor if you talk to the head miner. Yeah, and if you kill him, I don't know if this is, you know, represented in your history log, but he really did start out as hostile, so I'm not sure. Well, I can at least show you the loot before I commit to anything else. This we found some nice guns here, well, fairly good here. These M16A1s, they made themselves useful. I gave Vinny this other one as a secondary, and he used it to clear out some resistance here, some stragglers. That's fine. It will be equally as useful in the dungeon, I would assume. Yeah, the garden didn't even have it. Don't think she dropped anything, if I recall correctly. Yeah, and just some. Every single enemy on this map is hardcoded to use a gas mask, of course, to wear a gas mask, of course. It makes sense, you know, they have tear gas traps and everything like this. Yeah, why wouldn't they? So nothing too exciting in terms of loot, except for another PKM here. At least we can just sell for, I don't know, 7,000 bucks or something like this, yeah. Well, I will attempt to find some solution off screen and then show you the results next turn, because, well, we really got shafted over here. Really get shafted here, screwed over once again by the game, so I'm really quite upset about this. But I know you saw the civilians, they were hostile on site, and we had to take them all out. And you know, we used some HE grenades, but they didn't even go in the direction of the Nemo. And the tear gas that wasn't triggered by us, and it didn't even reach him. It's just the hallways, not in the cells themselves. So I'm not sure what went wrong there. Well. Regardless, I hope you enjoyed this episode. I certainly did have a fun time with it. So, well, once again, this dynamic situation is a little unfortunate, but what can you do? I will ponder about it off screen. So, yeah, thanks again for watching, and see you next time.